Hey guys, Harsh here, back in the video. So today I'm going to review the Tomahawk V50 Max from MSI, and it is a pretty good motherboard. We used it on our PC build, and if you want to check the PC build, we have given the link in the description below. So if you want to check that out, you can check that out. Okay, so now let's unbox the motherboard, and it is pretty well packed. You get the anti-static bag with it, so this will protect the motherboard from electric shocks or electrostatic shocks that you might damage the board because of it. Now this motherboard can support 1st, 2nd and 3rd generation AMD Ryzen processor, which is pretty vast majority of the AMD processor, and you can also use Vega Graphics desktop processor for socket AM4, and yes, this uses a AM4 socket for its processors. It supports DDR4 memory, which is pretty fast for this type of motherboard, and you can get blazing fast loading times with it, and it only has a 1x M.2 slot, so that's pretty upsetting because right now all of the things here are about M.2 and motherboards are mounting M.2 slots at the back of the motherboard to get more slots. Now, with steel armor PCI slot supports two-way crossfire. Audio Boost rewards your ear with studio-grade sound quality for the most immersive audio experience. Flash BIOS button simply uses a key to flash any BIOS within seconds without installing a CPU or memory or a graphic card. It has 4 SATA 6GBPS ports, and you can only use 4 SATA ports if you are using the M.2 slot, so that's a pretty misleading, I think, thing, because I don't know why they promise 6 SATA ports when you can only use 4 if you are using a M.2 slot. And it has a PCIe Gen 3 slots 4 times, so it has 4 PCIe Gen 4 slots. It has 1x DVI port at the back of the IO shield and 1x HDMI 4.0 port. It has 1x HDMI 1.4 port, and it can support a video output of 4K at 30fps. Now, PCIe Gen 3 slots are available also, so it has a 16x PCIe Gen 3 slot and a PCIe Gen 2 16x slot, so you get a total of 2 PCIe 16x slots, one is Gen 3 and one is Gen 2. And as I've told earlier, it has 3 PCIe Gen 2 slots, which are 1x. Now the DDR4 memory can support a maximum of 64GB of RAM, so you can get blazing fast speed for your computer, and you can have 16GB of RAM per DIMM, so that's pretty nice. And it has a dual channel memory architect and supports non-ECC UDIMMs. And here are some of the specifications that many people like to know. So here are the specification about the pin headers, USB ports and fan connectors. And to light up your PC, it has 2x RGB 15 12 volt slots, so you can power up your system with lights all over the place and make it like a disco place. And it also has support for USB Gen 3. Now let's talk about the gaming performance. So the gaming performance were achieved by using a Ryzen 3 1600 processor and a GTX 1050 Ti. So in GTA 5 we were getting an average of 62 FPS, which is I think pretty decent for this type of build. And in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 we were getting 43 FPS, which is the lowest that we have gotten. And in Watch Dogs 2 we get an average of 967 FPS. Then in NFS Payback we were getting the highest average FPS at 92 frames per second. And Far Cry 4 were decent at 60 FPS per second. Now it might vary at high settings or at 4K outputs or at 1080p outputs. Okay, so now we will gonna talk about the video rendering time which will be taken in Premiere Pro. When you talk about exporting a 4K video at 60 FPS, it took almost 220 seconds, which is pretty good for a 5-minute long video. And also when you talk about the 2K video at 60 FPS, it took just 2 minutes to export that video. I have to say that the video is not edited, like I have not put any VFX or any overlays like text and graphics. And when you are exporting a 1080p video at a 60 FPS, it's just take less than a minute. And also let's talk about other quality, which is 720p at 60 FPS, it just took half a minute. So also the time may vary if you are using a text and using some animations overlays like images and pictures. So this is just a simple video I have exported out. Also I have rendered the same video in Vegas Pro and got these results. Exporting a 4K video at 60 FPS, it took 230 seconds. It's just more than 10 seconds from Premiere Pro, because the Sony Vegas doesn't use a graphic card to export the video. And also when you're exporting a 2K video, it took 140 seconds, and a 1080p video at 60 FPS is took somewhere between 81 seconds, and also exporting a 720p video at 60 FPS just took 63 seconds. So these results are pretty much higher than Premiere Pro, because as I've said, Sony Vegas doesn't use your GPU to export videos. It just use your GPU to preview your editings on the screen. Now when you are talking about the overlays, like the best thing you come into your mind is After Effects. So here are some results from the After Effects. Exporting a video at 4K 60 FPS is 240, which is pretty good for a 5-minute long video, and exporting the same video at 2K at 60 FPS is just 151 seconds, which is a little bit more than 2 minutes. And also when you are talking about 1080p HD, full HD at 60 FPS, it took 61 seconds, which is a little bit much more than 1 minute. And also when you talk about the 720p at 60 FPS, it just took 42 seconds. Also I would like to mention that I have used some text over as a overlay, so it is pretty good for rendering in the video. So overall I have to say that this motherboard is pretty good. Hello guys, thanks for watching this video, hope you like it, and hopefully this video was so informative for you. So thanks for watching, please like, subscribe and share.